to go through security where they search your bags, grope your body, metal detector you, and then do it again, and then do it again, as you just said, but then no one ever scanned or checked their ticket, ever. Not even getting on the train. It was ultra bizarre. Jakari was like, well, wait a minute. There was all this security, but there was no security. And there were men with machine guns everywhere, police dogs, snipers, gunboats, five helicopters, jets flying over that weren't even... Yeah.
You know, Alex, the question needs to be asked this, and this is what I believe the people need to be asking the government, is why, if we're indeed that vulnerable and we're really that much under attack that the United States is now turning into East Berlin with its security precautions, we need to ask the million-dollar question. Why? What have we done? And I'll repeat that. What have we done to incur the anger of people throughout the world to this extent? Because that's what we need to be looking at. What is causing people to hate the United States to the extent that they are? We used to be looked up to. Everywhere in the world used to look up and try to emulate the United States of America. They all wanted to be us. You know, they all wanted that. But today, there's nobody doing that anymore. And if we have to lock down our country for fear of attack from some unknown entities, well, then we need to start looking in the mirror saying, what are we doing that is causing this type of behavior throughout the world? Because, you know, we certainly didn't have to protect our Super Bowls 20 years ago like this. I mean, naturally, there's always been some type of security at every event. But as you stated, the security was to make sure people had tickets, you know, because it used to be you had to worry about scalpers and people sneaking in.
Well, and you had real police out there who knew what to look for. You know what it is, Governor. It's about training us to be slaves, training us for the police state, training us for a lockdown America during a financial collapse. Why do you think they're setting up what I would call classical incremental martial law? What do you think it's in preparation for, Jesse Ventura?
Well, it troubles me greatly because obviously somebody feels there's going to be a need for martial law.
That's right.
And I can't for the life of me figure out if our society is what we deem it to be, why there would ever be a need for martial law. What in the United States of America? You know, people need to wake up and realize that they have, each of us as individuals, have about as much chance of being attacked by a terrorist as we do winning the Powerball. And yet, we're preparing like some sort of Al-Qaeda invasion of Normandy is going to happen at Virginia Beach, Virginia. And it's insane. And I have to agree with you, Alex. The people in the know must be preparing for something that they sure don't want us to know about, because this lockdown of America over 9/11 and over the Patriot Act is utterly absurd. It's time to get rid of the Patriot Act and take the country back to what it used to be instead of this police state they're turning it into.
My issue is they just keep accelerating it to where more and more it sounds like a good idea to leave the country like you've done. Shifting gears, I believe, as you've said, getting off the grid, becoming self-sufficient, that's how you make sure you can't be domesticated. This system wants you on food stamps. It wants you dependent. It wants you scared, not having your own guns, with police all around with guns. They want us domesticated. So I want to spend a few minutes before we get back into the news and this latest overdose and the heroin out of Afghanistan. I want to ask Governor Jesse Ventura, because I had a lot of fun being on your show last week, uncensored, and it was just great. I was on Skype. You were on Skype. Felt like I was there in the room with you. Spend a few minutes talking about some of the shows you're doing. I mean, you're doing them, what, 4 days a week at least, and some of the stuff that's coming up, because, I mean, this is the type of show that I personally am going to be watching.
Well, it's fun for me, Alex, because, as you know, since I left office, I've had a very difficult time getting my message out there. You stated earlier Fox News won't have me on, MSNBC won't have me on. CNN allows me on a little bit. My last book, because it dealt with the Kennedy killing, none of the major networks would have me on, not NBC, not ABC, not CBS, Fox, none of them. And I've always, since I got out of office in 2003, when I had that debacle that happened at MSNBC where they wouldn't put me on the air because I opposed the war in Iraq, and they paid me for 3 years and literally handcuffed me and kept me off the air. Since then, I've been fighting to find a way. How can I talk to the American people unfiltered? How can I talk to the American people without it being on these stations that decide whether I can come on or not? And Aura.com has come forward, and it actually happened while I was on a book tour. I did Larry King, and I thought Larry had retired. You know, I thought Larry left CNN. I didn't know that he was on the Internet. I said, Larry, what are you doing? He said, oh, I'm on the Internet. You need to be on this. And that's how it all started. Aura TV does Larry King, and they got interested then in me, and they felt I was a voice that needed to be heard. And the important thing is the owner of the company is not from the United States of America, so therefore he has no dog in the fight. When I want to criticize our policy and be an engaged American citizen and be vigilant, a term that I've been using from the start that I like to assume President Obama stole from me for the State of the Union address, because lo and behold, he also used the term vigilant. And this show has offered me that ability and to be able to, and I thought to myself, you know, I've been inside the United States yelling and screaming from the inside out, and nobody seems to want to listen. Maybe it'll work better from the outside going in. So that's what it's done for me doing this show. I can't tell you how happy I am. Uncensored, any topics I want to talk about. And, of course, it's on the Internet, so shows are roughly only 8 to 12 minutes long because that's the style of the Internet. They're more quick hits. You're not going to have an hour, hour and a half long show that's going to work that well. I don't think so. It works out terrific for me, and it lets me live in sheer freedom down here. And we'll be moving it about, too, the show, Alex. We don't want them to get a pinpoint on us. We don't want them finding us with drones. So we'll be doing the show from different locations off the grid. We'll keep them guessing.
Well, it's just really exciting, the revolution of true independent media. Larry King, when they kicked him off 3 years ago, had 2 million listeners, viewers a night. Piers Morgan, and I know you know him, he has you on, you know, it's down to about 400,000. MSNBC has gone from 1 million down to about 300,000. I mean, back when you were on MSNBC, they had 5 million viewers, 10 million viewers some nights. Mainstream media isn't just dying because of the Internet, because my show is just exploding and many others are. It's the content. But they're still, I mean, Larry King wasn't controllable enough for them, so they got him off CNN. And it just shows, what do you, Jesse Ventura, you're a smart guy, you're savvy. Where do you see the media wars going? Where do you see the establishment going? Where do you see just, you know, all the new banker bailouts, all the corruption? What is your gut about where the future of humanity is going?
Well, you know, to me, when you're talking communications, it's the Internet. I mean, you know, it's taking over so strong now. That's why I'm on it, the freedom of being on it. And you can rest assured the government is going to try to get control of it. They've got to, from their perspective. If they're going to control us, they got to control the Internet. I personally hope they never, ever get control of it. I love the freedom of it. It falls right under freedom of speech, our First Amendment and the Bill of Rights. We have the right to speak freely. And the Bill of Rights, freedom of speech, as I've said so often, it's there to protect unpopular speech. Because popular speech doesn't need protecting. It's unpopular speech that needs protecting.
That's right.
Or speech that goes against the status quo. It may be minority speech you're talking about here. Excuse me. Something that the majority doesn't necessarily can control. And that's what's important about the Internet.
Well, that's right.
So, Alex, I think the Internet, and I'm probably being very liberal here, I see the Internet taking over all communications within a decade.
Oh, I agree. Totally. No, I think you're right. Maybe 5-6 years. I mean, the way it's going. But cybersecurity, Homeland Security, they admit with big media, they want to censor it, track it, tax it, web ID it, and geo-locate it, geo-filter it, so that they can kill competition because these guys can't compete with us, Governor.
Well, you know, and that may be the case. It's like the old saying from Deep Throat, Alex, follow the money. The money will lead you. You know, that's money is what gets government to react. Money, money, money. If there's money to be made, government wants a piece of it. On another note, we'll switch gears here. Again, I want to talk about, you know, and we, this makes a good transition to the war on drugs that you wanted to talk about. I'm so proud of the states of Washington and Colorado, the two Super Bowl participants, but I'm even more proud of them, not for their Super Bowl football teams. I'm proud of them because they have voted the people in those states to legalize marijuana and strike a blow against this war on drugs that in a free society should never be happening. Drug addiction should be treated medically. Addiction should be treated medically, not criminally. You can be addicted to anything. People, imagine the addiction to coffee. Now, and that's a powerful addiction. I remember when I was in the Navy. If you didn't make the coffee, the chiefs were ready to hang you from the yardarm. You know? And I never drink coffee. I've never been a coffee addict. But when you watch people not get their morning cup of coffee and you watch how it affects them in their daily life, clearly it's a powerful addiction. Well, again, addiction, you can be addicted to Hostess Twinkies, for that matter.
Exactly. You're not going to arrest people for sugar, though now Bloomberg, the outgoing mayor, wants that. Let me shift gears before we get into the drugs,
sure,
because I want to tie it in. We're about to go to break. I'm going to come back and talk about the dead actor who I was a fan of. He was a great actor, and this super heroine that killed him, and tie it in, you know, to how the drugs are being shipped in from Afghanistan, and get your take on that. But since you mentioned censorship of journalism and the internet, as you know, we'll put the LA Times article on screen. Los Angeles Times, who's a journalist, Senator Dianne Feinstein, wants to draw a line and literally shut down bloggers, talk radio, you name it, and not let us have journalistic protections. She's absolutely a monster. And you've got John D. Rockefeller, the senator from West Virginia, saying, quote, we'd be better off if the internet was never invented. So I agree with you. And I remember calling you the night and calling Tyrell the night. I've never done this on the TV show, even though I was involved in, like, at that time, like 10 episodes of the 16 or so that had been on. And I'll never forget calling you as a consultant and saying, Governor, I just want to say congratulations for putting the most powerful television on ever. Your FEMA special exposes the whole takeover plan, the whole plan with the FEMA centers. I cannot believe this got on air with almost 2 million viewers, record views for a new show on True TV. Then Congress gets involved, all of it happens, the way you scared that congressman, and they killed it airing again when they normally air it 50 more times, so it's seen by upwards of 50 million people. Most re-airs have a million viewers. Incredible to see that that so threatened the establishment that within hours they flipped out. Can you speak to that?
Well, it was, I don't know if you want to call it an honor to be taken down on the congressional floor, but that's what actually happened. Congressman Cohn, the guy who co-sponsored the bill to build these FEMA camps, actually chastised me and my show on the floors of Congress. And I guess I should take that for a compliment to get that far. But you're right. That show never aired again. They then removed it and wouldn't even acknowledge that we did it.
They took it off TiVo. They took it off the cable servers.
Oh, yeah. They did all that. So people out there that believe that we're not already being operated under a certain censorship are naive and sadly mistaken, and they better wake up to the fact that, you know, even a show like mine, when it comes out and tells the truth on a particular subject, if it offends too many of the status quo or the government, they'll step in and do what they did to that show and basically remove it so that more people can't ever see it. But it's still out there. Because the great thing about the internet today is once it's shown once, it's going to be somewhere.
Well, we're going to break, but I want to come back and get into the drug war, other key issues that you're focused on. But I wanted to raise that because people better appreciate PrisonPlanet.tv, the InfoWars Nightly News, our subscription service. They better appreciate Governor Ventura and ORATV, /Off the Grid, Aura TV. They better appreciate that Ventura, 4 days a week, is producing a show, that 6 days a week we're doing it. It's hard work. We're all in this together. We love freedom is why we do it. But it's not pearls before swine. Understand, folks, we're busting our butt, and the enemy, the establishment, does not like this. We've gone through a lot of trouble, a lot of threats, a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff Ventura doesn't want people to even know about, and that's fine. I won't talk about it. I've been through it, too, so we're brothers in arms in those shared experiences of trying to use our First Amendment and being so effective. Look at all the JFK people that have been killed or targeted. I want to talk about that with Ventura as well when we come back. But this is serious. This is war. So support us.
We're on the march.